For patients with recurrent endometrial cancer, I think this is, you know, a time of true excitement. There's more focus on therapies for patients. We understand the cancer better. And, you know, just within the past 1 to 2 years, there's really now a framework of how to think about patients with recurrent endometrial cancer. I think a big distinguisher has been the level of microsatellite instability or unstableness, MSI high or microsatellite stable. The pan microsatellite instable FDA approval, at least in the United States, of pembrolizumab was a significant game changer a few years ago. And that helped us divide our patients with recurrent disease into microsatellite stable, where a single agent pembro does not have an approval, versus microsatellite instable, where pembrolizumab does have an approval for these patients. Other factors to consider are the underlying histology. So high-grade endometrioid, high-grade serous, those are the tumors that tend to be microsatellite stable, whereas lower-grade endometrioid tumors have a higher chance of being microsatellite instable. So the trial that's been presented by my colleague, Dr. Joyce Liu from the Dana-Farber Cancer Institute, I'm a co-author on this abstract, is looking at the WEE1 inhibitor, Adavosertib, in patients with recurrent endometrial serous cancers. And what she found was there was a really remarkable 30% overall response rate looking at and testing single agent WEE1 inhibitor. So it's AZD1775, or the name is Adavosertib. It's a bit of a tongue twister, but Adavosertib. And it's a drug that has been tested in a number of different settings. And this is really the first time that we've seen significant activity of this drug as a single agent in recurrent serous cancers. We saw, again, as I said, about 30% response rate. I personally have currently had patients on this trial. And the drug really does have activity. I had patients who were heavily pretreated, who were not responding to either, you know, combination chemotherapy or single agent chemotherapy, where the drug really nicely shuts down cancer growth, leading to a response. The toxicities were really bone marrow toxicities, some myelosuppression, some diarrhea and fatigue, and a lot of that can be managed with dose holds and potentially dose reductions. So I think it really represents an additional therapy now, and hopefully it's moving forward in other trials, but an additional therapy for our patients with endometrial serous cancers, where that is different than high-grade serous ovarian cancer, where you do see more underlying homologous recombination deficiencies, BRCA mutations. Serous cancers and endometrial cancer are sensitive to platinum, but the response rates are just not as robust. And I think overall, that's a harder to treat cancer. Chemotherapy doesn't play much of a role. So I'm really excited about these results and excited to see this drug move forward.